press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello friends, this is Nirav Gohil here and welcome to LTS Talks. Today again I have four topics, so without wasting time, let's start. So the first topic is for LTS speaking, which is how to speak on any random topic. So guys, I will share three tips. So let's start with the first one, which is practice. Do practice. At least practice 200 cooker topics. Trust me, then after it will be like a correlation, like a favorite food and traditional dish. You can correlate, right? So at least practice 200 cooker topics. And now the question is, where to find 200 cooker topics with answer? It's very easy. I have already created one Android application and I have already published. You will get link in the description. So tip number two is bluff. Even if you don't have idea about the topic, make a story, bluff, but speak. As you are knowing, this taste of English language proficiency, not your knowledge. So bluff, but speak. And tip number three is three sub-questions. Your focus should be on three sub-questions and collect your content accordingly. So guys, focus on these three things. Trust me. Then after it will be like piece of cake for you to answer any cooker topic. So guys, that's it for the first topic. Let's solve on the second topic. The second topic is for LTS writing, which is use of examples. So there are basically two tasks, writing task 1 and 2. So let me start with writing task 1. Do not share any example in writing task 1. No matter you are an academic student or a general student, do not share any example. And when it comes to writing task 2, if your question demands, then share example or else do not share any example. I hope things are clear for you now. If your question demands in writing task 2, then share example or else do not. So guys, this is really very important. So that's it for topic number 2, let's talk about topic number 3. So the third topic is for LTS reading, which is answers in the sequence. Let me ask you one simple question. In reading examination, will you get all your answers in the sequence? No. It depends on question type. Let me explain this thing with one simple example. In fill in the blanks, you will get all your answers in the sequence. But what about list of headings? You will not get answers in the sequence. So, as I already told you, it depends on question type. So, understand each and every question type properly and make your own strategy. This is really very important. Make your own strategy. With the help of single strategy, you will not be able to get all correct answers. So, make your own strategies and understand question types properly. So, that's it for topic number 3. Let's talk on the topic number 4. The last topic is for LTS listening, which is diagram and maps. So total I will share 3 tips. So let's start with the first one, which is start point. Your focus should be on the start point because speaker will start his speech from there only. So never miss your start point. Your focus should be on the start point. Right, let's talk on the tip number 2, which is an overview. Take an overview. Observe your diagram really very carefully and remember all labeled items like lake, tree, benches, opera house. Remember all labeled items. Guys, trust me, it will help you a lot. Remember all labeled items. And the last tip is directional arrows. In diagram and maps, your questions will not be in the sequence. It will not be like 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. It will be like 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So after each answer, you will ponder for your next question. So make a directional arrows. So like 11, so now 12, then 13, then 14, then 15, then 16. Make a directional arrow. So once you get answer of question 12, you will be able to switch immediately. So make directional arrows. So guys, that's it for the last topic. If you have any question regarding to these four topics or any other topics, feel free, comment section is for you. I will talk to you there. So that's it for this video. I hope you like this video and enjoyed it. If you like, do not hesitate, straight away hit the like button and share with your friends. If you are a new user and watching my video first time, hit the subscribe button along with the bell icon to get notifications. Do not forget to hit that bell icon. And if you want to do proper IELTS practice, try my applications. Links are in the description. So soon I will come back with new study material and tips for you. Till then, keep practicing. Bye bye.